David, just why is this report potentially so damaging?
Well, it's very damaging because it really points the finger from an official body here in South Africa to the president, to top ministers, and other members of the high and mighty here in South Africa, and gives evidence and allegations of high levels of corruption and cronyism, including the appointment of ministers for alleged kickbacks, dodgy state-owned enterprise dealings that the president is alleged to have turned a blind eye to. Really, in 355 pages describing in detail the levels of corruption that seem to have been going on for some time here in South Africa, all the way up to the presidency. Hannah?
Calling for him to resign, but it's not the first time he's been embroiled in scandal and controversy throughout his presidency. If Jacob Zuma refuses to budge, what happens next?
Well, one can assume that at least in the short term, he will refuse to budge, despite what we saw on the streets today, which were opposition parties, many of thousands of them protesting, as well as business and even members of the ruling ANC out on the streets today, calling for the resignation of Jacob Zuma. This really, on some level, just moves this forward, and the timeline is a little bit unclear. He has to, according to this report, make that judicial inquiry happen. That's got several months of timeline, and it's unlikely, given the history we know of Jacob Zuma, the fact that he's withstood these scandals before, that he's going to willingly go, even if there is a great deal of pressure put on him. And as the time slips by, and maybe the initial euphoria of this report for those who support the president leaving fades, it will become more difficult to unseat him. He, next year, towards the end of the year, faces a challenge potentially within his own party as his second term winds down. But it's still a very serious allegations against the president, and it could mean he's pressured out by his own party. It certainly is the most difficult period he's faced, and the biggest victory for those who want to push the rule of law here in South Africa.